Alright, so, how y'all doing, boys? Hope you're doing well. Now, in today's video, probably going to be the last Malicia team I use for a little bit. I might end up using her alongside the Festival DM when she releases, but there were a couple teams I was tossing up between, and this one just seemed to be the most interesting. I haven't done a damage reduction team like this probably since this King actually released. I used him pretty much in this exact same team. Not too sure who I replaced Malicia with. Probably would have been Gothra, in all honesty, just for to rank up the King cards in order to get a stronger shield, but I feel like this will work really, really well. Unfortunately, I still haven't gone ahead and made the Malicia lifesteal gear. I really want to do it, but at the same time, I don't know, there's something holding me back. I do not know why, but we are, of course, working her instead on the HP defense set. And when it comes to the cosmetics, not a crazy amount of investment. She does have some upgrades, but this Malicia is an absolutely amazing character. I'm not going to go over all of her cards, but going over the commandment, same commandment as all the other Malicias. The end of every turn applies 2 ignite effects for 5 turns on heroes who have not used skills in PvP. Now, usually this could actually end up being our dense So, looking at the commandment here, at the end of every turn applies 2 ignite effects for 5 turns on heroes who have not used skills in PvP. Now, usually this could be a downside, because if you didn't use a card of a character on your own team, they would actually have those ignite effects applied to them. But with this Malicia here and her passive, increase all allies' stats by 20% of heroes' lifesteal at the start of battle. Allies become immune to ignite up to 20%, so not only do they not have the ignite effect on them, but the actual debuff doesn't appear on them either. So characters that kind of thrive off putting debuffs on enemies, for example, the Christmas Awakened Lilia, and characters in the back like Zel'Jus as well, this is going to be completely negating a whole bunch of the work they are going to be doing. So really, really nice character, really good job of Kanan Ki, who's really, really common character despite the fact he is so exclusive, but this is the theme we're using today. Haven't tried it out yet. We are rocking the resistance food, so could be a little tough going second in a couple of these matchups. But I mean, yeah, let's jump right into it. And let's hit our first opponent, the infamous Kyo Lilia team. And they have a whole bunch more CC than us. Definitely a real player. The fact that we are disabling Kyo and Christmas Week and Lilia pretty much entirely from doing everything is pretty helpful. But Trader Meliodas is just so insanely strong that, like, I'm pretty sure it was in probably the last showcase I did with the Valentine's Day Malicia, we ended up versing a team exactly like this, and we still lost just due to the fact that Meliodas can just do so much work. It's so absurd what that man is capable of doing. Like, even without ignites, like if we had ignites on us there, we were easy dead turn one. This team is just so, so powerful. But let's see, what do I want to go for here? This increases defense related stats, so that could be pretty helpful with doing just like a tiny bit more damage with King. Let's see, I might just go for this, in all honesty. The only reason I did that is so we could probably get like a little bit of extra card draw on the next turn, but once we get this King Shield up, we should be patiencing pretty well, or at least even if we aren't patiencing, just, you know, put a crazy amount of damage reduction. If we can get a couple turns in where we can get 2 King cards out, or even an ultimate especially, that would be really, really good for us. Only downfall about this though is the Malicia Shield is pretty much useless, so we should be able to actually damn, okay, even with the fact that he had the Pierce card there, which is the best card for breaking King Shield, we actually managed to survive the first half, so not completely terrible. Damn, King is taking an absolute beating here. I mean, if we could have a buff removal character, that'd be extra nice to kind of stop Meliodas here. I do think I'm just going to go ahead and rush the ultimate for King there. If he doesn't have any melee cards, we're going to be completely fine, but that is such a hard thing to bet on. Like, he's had pretty good card draw up until this point. And let's see, we're pretty much just betting everything on that. Sorry to use a melee card. If that's a single target card, that's... oh, damn, it's still just absolutely one-tap the shield there. Please survive this melee. I mean, sorry, King. Please have, like, a Kyo card or something. Oh my god, I was holding my breath that whole time. Okay, we just managed to survive with King. Do I... okay. Gonna go for this here. Get the damage reduction before we throw out the ultimate there. Let's see, pretty much going to get no damage out of that card there just due to how many stacks the melee has on him. I'm hoping this can kill. King has a really weak ultimate, but never mind, I take that back. Nice 1 million damage. I mean, the fact that this is kind of a joke team and we beat a player with that much CC is actually absurd. Here we go, second opponent here, and sorry about, you know, starting so late into this one, but honestly, that first match, I'm just completely happy with how that went. Like, honestly, that by itself, like, I'm absolutely shocked at how well we did there. But let's see, coming up against another Kyo team is very lucky for us. I feel like it's not that often you get like back-to-back Kyo matches, especially since this Maleska is released. I don't know. I feel like she's definitely deterred them just a little bit, but let's see. I think we might actually go ahead and go for pretty much the same player. Once again, just trying to maximize card draw. As long as we're reeling in those king cards, we should be good to go. I would probably like to get a 2-star Genesis card just because we can decrease how much damage our opponent is doing, but it is what it is. I feel like if we were to have the Malestia maxed out on the lifesteal rolls as well, we would easily be patiencing like a whole bunch of these attacks, but let's see. I don't actually know if I want to go ahead and use the merge version of the Malestia single target because that will stop us from getting another, like, you know, we're not guaranteed any ult drain in this next turn, so could be a little bit scary going for that one. Not like we can rush the King Ultimate and remove Ultimate Gauge as well, so a little bit scary there. We'll actually go ahead and do this one first, just to get a tiny bit more damage out on the Meliodas there. Gosh, she's just built up so many buffs, like that's the thing. Although Kyo isn't like the greatest here, he does still have a single target card, so he's not completely useless. We are going to be trying to keep him alive for as long as possible, and I mean, would you look at that, even Molescula is doing damage. She's on a HP defense set, as you saw at the beginning of the video. Can we... This is honestly looking absolutely terrible here. I don't think we have enough damage with this to kill. I mean, we do get the rupture effect, which is nice, but like so many stat increase buffs on Melly. I think what he's procced is second half 3 times now, so almost maxed out on the defensive capabilities as well for him. He hasn't got ultimate, so it's not the end of the world. We are probably going to... am I better off rushing King instead? I think I might actually go ahead and do that. 1-2, and we will throw this out as well. Not really going to worry about the Kyo whatsoever. I mean, we don't get the extra ignites applied on us anyways. It's more just getting this Meliodas out of the way. He is such a threat. It's actually absurd. Not even himself, but he's passive. And Valenti actually managing to kill there? Yo, maybe I'm downplaying her just a tiny bit. I mean, I should have probably made her Holy Relic as well before the showcase. I haven't grinded the bird in a little bit, so... Actually, by the time you're seeing this, is probably after. I do plan on recording a video for the bird, so that might actually be up before this one is, but let's see. I mean, fortunately for us, he didn't get the level 2 Demonic Zone card for Zeldris. That does, of course, ultimate seal, and like I said, we really don't have to worry about Kyo. Like, not only is his ultimate not the greatest, but he just... The no ignites, it's just... We counter him so goddamn hard. Let's see here. I might go one... a little bit scary. I might go for this instead, just so we have a shield, just in case. Actually, we do get the King Shield regardless. Why would I even bother, right? King would just kill here, surely. Okay, King doesn't kill. It's not like they stack either. I mean, it is a blue buff and a gray buff, but yeah, not gonna happen. And we wouldn't have killed regardless there. Actually, we had done that first. Probably could have got the defense value stats. Yeah, we probably could have killed there, but that's all right. Let's see. Actually, for the, you know, intent of the showcase, I decided to let Escanor get his ultimate off just so we could show how easily we could survive. I mean, look at that. It doesn't even break King's shield. I mean, man is just way too powerful. Let's see. We'll kind of throw this Maleska ultimate off here. I've actually been fairly surprised with how much damage she does with this ultimate. It's really, really good. And she lifesteals all of the damage she does. So, especially at 6-6, pretty much full healing all of the time. So, that's really nice as well. And I mean, I feel like I might say this quite a bit during the video, but I am just still so surprised that we managed to win those first two matches. Once again, getting his goddamn Valentine's Day Molescular single target card, which we really don't want. Who can we go for? I suppose we can just go ahead and... Yeah, why not? We'll go for... I might actually go for this card first, just whilst they don't have all of, like, their buffs and their shields up and their Tarmiel stance. Might as well just try and get as much damage as possible onto the... Damn, they're patiencing us at this point. Just trying to get as much damage on the Margaret as possible with the strong guard. It's not like a huge damage difference, but it's going to help out in the long run. Okay, I could imagine, yeah, this team is so annoying. I downplayed it heaps, but I started to realize just how good it is. Like, there's so many scenarios where, like, if you get the right luck and, you know, rushing like a Tarmiel ultimate and whatnot is so powerful. I think that might be one of our first patiences we've seen in the video. Getting two of them, okay. I mean, hey, not too bad. I might actually go for the... Pretty much the same thing. We will get this card here. And as long as you can't break the shield, like remove the ultimate from our Valenti, and as long as we don't have to go through a shield as well, that is a big one. Actually, we do have the rupture effect, which... Okay, no, this is actually really good. We should be able to just go through the shield and manage to kill the enemy. We'll see about that one. I'm not like totally sure on that statement, but goddamn, these shields as well are just not doing it for us. I mean, we could actually rush the melee ultimate the melee ultimate, the king ultimate. I'm just so used to using melee over king, like, I don't know, I just prefer, you know, a whole bunch more. Once again, another patience, and actually managing to patience the Holy Blade card as well. Like, this team's damage isn't the greatest in the world, but I mean, it is still fairly good. The Tamiya ultimate does just completely one tap team, so let's go for this here. I was gonna go for the king ultimate just to play it safe. We are going to throughout the damage reduction card anyways. I feel pretty confident in having Valenti kill here, especially after what she did in that first match, and actually completely forgetting about revive. I'm very glad I went for that there. Removing the buff though, let's get actually doing once again just a tad bit of damage. Her having the ultimate here, we can definitely break through a shield with like a king card into a Valenti single target, but I don't know how confident once again I feel on that play. The mono blue is just so goddamn annoying. We haven't actually taken damage this entire fight though, which is pretty nice. I believe a level 3 shield. I don't know how I feel about going through that though. I mean, we might as well give that best shot, right? Why not? We'll go for this here. I don't think we're actually going to make a shield with King either, just because... Oh yeah, no, we are definitely not getting through the shield, jeez. This is actually going to do no damage whatsoever. Well, it could still do... No, actually. Yeah, no, 83,000, that is pitiful damage from Leska. Only a level 2 shield as well, because it disappeared after that first turn. Okay, I mean, the fact that we've got the King Ultimate here, if he doesn't drain it, we've just instantly won the match. We remove the buffs from them, we get extra buffs for ourselves. Him refreshing the Margaret buff is completely useless. We might be versing a bot. I'm not too sure on that one. Took damage for the first time in the match as well, which is really nice. The only time we didn't have the King Shield up. And more buffs for him means more damage for us. We'll throw out the King Ultimate. Unfortunately, no King cards before it to get extra damage. I mean, Valenti, or should I say Maleska, has been doing very good here. The Ultimate Reduction card is really nice, and the Lifesteal is really handy, but I don't know. The fact that we didn't kill everyone there as well. Don't get me wrong, I do only have a 3-6 king. My summons were just so bad for him. I'm actually kind of amazed just at how unlucky I got. Two whole rotations, and I think I got my first actual king, or I should say my only king. And I think it was the, like, 1,000 gem mark. So it is what it is. It's how gacha games work. I'm really hoping my luck on the DN is just a tiny bit better. My luck on melee wasn't the greatest either, so... Hey, once again, it is what it is. Having the stun thrown out here, please shield through this. Oh, okay, damn. Once again, not taking damage. Can we, instead of just bothering to attack into them whatsoever, go for this here and we will put up the shield again. I mean, the card draw on that was actually amazing. I think this is the first time I've actually got a level 3 molecular shield in PvP, which is pretty cool. We'll see how well we tank, but yeah, more damage. Well, should I say, more buffs on him. More damage for us once again. Removing the reflector as well. I don't really check ultimate levels too often in PvP, but the reflector is just like you don't want to attack into, especially if you have such a powerful AoE character. The second you're just like a tiny bit of damage off killing your opponent, it just completely one taps you. I might go ahead and throw out the... I mean, we only really need like the damage, like the damage boost from the actual card, so not like we have to throw out the 3-star. We will keep it till the very end though. I can imagine this is easily going to break King Shield. Never mind, we're still at 4. Okay, another ultimate here, and onto our second final opponent, I believe. Here we go, and another Traitor Melee Arsenal team. I feel like this is pretty much the bread and butter of PvP at the moment. The fact you actually got the Merger on that single target card, just a little bit scary, that's for sure. Going second as well is such a bad thing. Like, I recently did the stages 16, 17, and 18 of Tower of Trolls, and every single fight you have to go second, and especially with like the crazy amount of substats you get for like pretty much like the gimmicks in the fight, it's just so hard to like have to tank that first turn. But let's see, not actually proccing both halves of the melee passive. I don't know how I feel about this. What do I want to go for? I think we might go for this here. We'll save the Merge King cards for another turn. It's not like we can rush ultimate anyway, especially if he keeps that dissolve chain on us. I highly doubt he'll be able to, especially with how strong the King Shields are. Unless he's like using melee masking or cards to actually break the shields just to apply the dissolve. Which once again seems like just a little bit of a waste, but we should be able to rush ultimate this next turn as long as he doesn't do so himself. After that, we should be able to win the match. We'll also get like an extra bit of damage on Meliodas just because he passively gives himself buffs. Okay, damn, that's not completely... I mean, it is his flood card. It's one of the strongest cards in the game. Especially since the Christmas Awaken Lily has had it. And holy, was that more damage than I would have liked to have taken. Unking. Yeah, no, I'm definitely pretty confident in using that as my play and that being the best play for this turn. I mean, at this point, it's looking like another victory. I am amazed at how well this is actually working. I do not remember it working this well when I used King. Actually, almost killing with just the King cards alone, so I feel like we'll be fine here. Yeah, we get another King AoE. We can get the damage boost. If you guys have these units built, I would highly recommend it, and I honestly don't know what the Valenti Holy Relic is, but might have to have a look and see if it's like that crazy. I did hear about it being fairly good, but hearing it and actually like using it in play are two different things. Oh my god. Even with all of like the damage reduction and everything we have, Melee can just still so easily put out numbers like that. We will go for this here just to play it safe, a little bit of extra damage reduction on the Meliodas there, but that should just finish it up. Okay, sweet. Everyone survived there. Unfortunately, they do have the extra defense and whatnot, so not going to be the strongest ultimate possible, but we hit 1 million in this video, which I'm happy enough with that. 500,000, we still wiped everyone on the field. And onto our final opponent. No way did I think we would get the chance to say that we are going to have a flawless, or at least a chance to have a flawless video on this one. I think this might actually be the same guy we faced at the beginning of the video. I'm not too sure. The CC and the name definitely look familiar, so I mean, hey. What a way to start the video, and hopefully what a way to end the video. Completely patiencing against KO there. It's kind of what you expect at this point. And here is his melee card that is going to do way too much damage. Okay. Oh. We get the 4, but I'm not going to end it there. We're definitely going to do another one. And although I am going to be doing a 6 match, and this is a 6 match, I am still claiming my flawless video right there. We did all 5 matches, and we emerged victorious in all of them, even though that final one was an instant forfeit. Hey, we could possibly lose this one, so you never know. Using a Tarmiel himself, so got quite a bit of damage reduction in his team here. I mean, not doing a crazy amount of damage with the King there, which definitely helps out. Let's see, what do I want to go for? Yeah, using that as well. Okay, I mean, he has kind of got like the same thing going as us. I think if we actually go for the stronger... how do I feel here? Go for the stronger card here, and I think we'll just chuck out this card here just to get rid of it. We don't really like, it's not crazy important here. Actually, patiencing. Oh my god, okay. Yeah, so once again, we didn't get the strongest King Shield either. This is going to be a lot of back and forth and a really long match. We could rush King Ultimate here, especially if he doesn't get the Dissolve on us, but he does still, of course, have that time yellow single target, so trying to get through that can be scary. He does still have an extra King card as well, which we can see here, so going for that definitely isn't the play. He can pretty much break our shield. Guaranteed. Oh yeah, that's a lot of damage. I have to still feel like I'm going to merge those. Go for this here, and maybe just merge you as well. Once again, just freeing up more card space. We don't really need to use any other cards. King is pretty much carrying us here. Like, don't get me wrong, the two girls are doing like a whole bunch of work passively, but when it comes to the actual cards, we are entirely just wanting to be drawing the King cards. Let's see here. We didn't actually get any shield either. Oh god. Oh no. And he has 2 King cards, and he still has that gold card, which I believe is a King card as well. Damn, I told you we do have a high chance of actually, especially with just the streak we've gone on in those last couple, pretty good chance of losing this one here. We are taking way too much damage from that card alone. What did I say? I still claimed my flawless video on that 5th match, so this doesn't count. This doesn't count, I'm telling you, it doesn't. But there we go, that just about does it for today's video. Honestly, I enjoyed this one a bunch, and I really hope you guys did too. A little bit of a weirder team, but hey, it still worked. Sitting on around 200 gems, so really, really hoping we do get this Festival of Dien in this next update. They've delayed both of our previous updates, the Saria and the Maleska, so please don't do it again. I just want to be able to play with the new unit before they're 2 weeks old, but that just about does it for today's video. Really hope you guys enjoyed. Please hit the like button and subscribe. Really means a lot to me, and I'll see you guys for some more Grand Cross content.